Shomen.
Rotation.
Good. You're just stretching up. Nice deep breath in. And keeping the length, bending the knees. Oh, yeah. Draw up through the hip. Go back up through the spine. Stretching back up. To the side, right at one side. Roll in the shoulders, backwards. Forwards. Nice big circles to the back. To the side. Circle in the Twist into the back of the elbow. Extend it out with both hands. Hold it and then chin. Legs a little bit wider, just squatting the body down. Hold it. With the hands on the knees, just start to twist through the spine. Looking right over the shoulder, twisting the whole spine. The other way. It's coming down, and kind of fingertips on the ground with a hand. Just using the elbows, just pressing against the knee. Side to side, the body. Hold it one side, keeping both feet flat. Okay. Bring the toes up. Keep that. Change. Change. Feet out, stretch again. Hands on the same line. And bending from the pelvis. Let the low knee. Slowly working at the interior. Just until you can get into the fingertip. And then right to the shoulders. Left into the spine. All the way from the top of the head to the lower back. Pressing one hand down into the ground. And the hips kind of tilt it back a little bit. And raise the hand up and back a little bit slower, just 10 each side. Bring the hand down and reach it. The torso. Bring it slide. Thank you.
bringing the legs back. Here, a little bit closer together, pressing through the hands, and just work through the feet. So if you're kind of pressing the heel down behind the hand. And then bring your knees right up here. Stretch out a little bit more.
Can you just go to the knee? Roll through them.
Okay.
Let's just try and keep the contact with the feet on the ground. Direction. The ankles. Roll them off the ground. And press through the ball of the foot and extend right. Side, balance on the one leg. Point, press the pole. Back. More to the side. And then rolling with the knee. You're trying to open the hip out. And then change the side with the leg. Front and back. To the side. Rolling in the arm, roll the arm, and include the shoulders, elbows, forearms, wrists, and make everything move. Slow. Little wrist here. Here we go. Got a coordination. And make the wrist come over the top. Chin. Yeah. Thumb in the middle of the palm. Twisting out the center. And taking the fingers, stretch all the way through the arm. The other. Press them out, nice and fast. The full extension, but nice and fast. That's about 50. Tight fist. Shake the wrist out. Circle the arm. And then in the whole arm. Good. Okay, we'll do some bokken today. Okay, so just start with this nice and easy, all the width apart. Just reach in the back, dropping the hips down, all the way through. Just slicing down, nice and balanced. Let the knees release. Keep length through the spine. Just roll through one nice clean arc. Okay, just watch with this exercise. Really try and do this with no force, no power whatsoever, and really forget the cut. So forget the idea of kind of impacting with the cut. What you don't want to do in this case is kind of cut into the ground like this kind of work. So in a sense, it's not like a low cut, but the sense is really to get into the position and then just release through the sword, release through the body. So there's nothing in the cut left. There's no sense of impacting with the cut. Just a sense of drink. You just release the sword. Find the back, really nothing in it. Yeah. Find the back and then roll through it. But not the sense of kind of cutting it to the ground. Find the body and release the soul. Nice and relaxed. That's it. And then you come into a hammy, right hammy, and do the same exercise. So just bring the back, kind of like a column all the way through the body here, and then just come in forward, release the cup. Again, just really release. Release the cup. Really all the focus is in the body and grounded here. Find the back. And also, in this case, really, because of the hip, but I don't want to show from this one. Just drop down and this is this position. What I want is to hip forward. I don't want to put the body forward with it, but I need the hip also shift with it. Both the hips are shifting with the movement and spiraling down into the ground. A little bit like when you do the coffee where it's like this, but it's not like this. And it's down here. So get the sense of the whole body kind of moving forward. Even though you don't move the back foot, shift the hip through the movement. So it's like the whole body's going to shift in. That's not
Michael,
yeah.
Do you tilt your pelvis a little bit forward?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah, I'm gonna let that. This is also part of what's happened a little bit now because you saw this change thing, but what's happened a little bit. With some of these, like now the needles,
yeah.
Now you've got like this feeling. So now they're doing it by bending the knee this way. Yeah, like with the pelvis actually is also this way. Yeah, but I'm not doing it by bending the leg by bending the knee. The knee's loose, but it.
Yeah, it doesn't collapse. It doesn't
collapse. So just get this, yeah, the pelvis is going to feel. That
way. Yeah. So, yeah. If you would look, it tilts a little bit this direction.
Yeah, it's gonna go just tilt this way. Yeah. That.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's it. And just try the same left side too, so just look for the same, slightly different configuration with the hands, but look for the same feeling, draining down. The grips now reverse, opposite. And shift the movement to the body. Okay, good. We just work this kind of feeling into a Zengoku. So it's slightly different to what we're kind of used to doing. So here, find the ground this way, and then what I want you to do is rotate up and find this position, and then just shift it. You're going to find this position first. You're just above the head, and then just shifting the hips down. Now you've got both on the ceiling up, rotating, raising the sword, but sinking down, and then just shifting the hips in. Find the position. Rotate, find the top of the head, and shift the hip in. Great. Isolating the
rotation up.
And then just bring it together, so just slide through each side, coming to here, rolling up, coming down, to the back, getting down. All the time keeping the weight settling down, especially in the rotation. Settling down. The knees might be relaxed, open. And then just bring in the focus. It's like a basic Zengoku. Keeping the same movement, the same focus in the body, but just now bringing in the hands. While you're making the impact. Super stable. Yeah. And we go to number two, so. The weight draining down. And the back end really shifting the hip forward now. Now, really advancing with the hips, try and keep the same sense of stability. Okay, just be careful in this movement of finding the back. One of the tendencies of this move is they can kind of pull the body up, and then the movement is basically being pulled up over the hips off the ground, and then you've got to re-find the ground. So allow, when you find the back, allow the body to sink down. Yeah, and then shift the hips in. So find this position. The hips are kind of low, and then release through the hips, find the ground, find the back, and then push through. Just be careful that it doesn't do this. I kind of pull up with the hips up. The body, especially when you raise, drains down. Alright, be careful on that moment.
Thank you, Mike. See you later, guys.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Good. We're going to five. So just go on the spot. And just again, just go back to this kind of idea of releasing. And now the angle's different. I'm going to allow the hips now to open the movement out. So just do this first thing this way. Just bringing the feet together, finding the top of the head. And this part, the kind of base of the thumb and the hand. Just finds the top of the head here. So each time, just find this position through the body and then let the back hip open out. So press the hip in, find the top of the head, and then come back and just cut down. So just release through the. And again, look for the sense of spiraling now. The hips are more open. I've got a slightly bigger spiral with the body. So just find this, find the top of the head, and then just draw it down. Nice and calm. One, two, into the ground. One, two, one, two. Give it a try. And the danger in this move, because it's on the spot, performed on the spot, and the leg's coming back, the feeling's that the body starts to shift back. But in this case, have the sense that the body's spiraling down onto the ground. But keep the center's actually not gonna shift places. You can feel it, and then the center shifts down. It doesn't shift back. So just because you come in, center just spirals down into the ground. Kind of moving around the center. This place is kind of stuck. Just finding. And then start to just bring this all together. But just find the top of the head, bring the foot back. Find the top of the head, bring it down. Okay, and then just coming through with the steps. So just start with the right side forward. Just do one cut each time. Just step through and continue. Now, really try and impact the slice or the arc of this cut with the impact of the ground with the feet. So try and really time this together so you can feel one thing and then come back. One cut. Do a few each side, so you can do left and right. Just take it one step. One step, one cut. Have a sense of impacting the ground with the cut. And the same just really now with the focus, so coming through and focusing through. You get a sense of the focus in the hands and the, there's a, as you focus with the hands, there's also the pressure in the feet. Work on basically this timing between the hands and the feet. The other side. And it's all to each side, just do this one cut at a time. Take your time with it. And then just link two cuts together, so starting on the right side. And then really find the ground, and then just straight into the next one. Just two cuts. Keep a nice focus, really coordinating the hands and the feet. Each time, really a sense of impacting into the ground, compressing down to the feet. A little bit but let's really transfer the impact of the sword and the compression into the feet just straight away into the next one. So just two, we try to feed off the first attack and get that and then come straight in nice and clean into the ground right into the next attack. You get them in the sense of just nice and basic, just kind of right in here, great your minutiae, and then just pressing forward. The other is kind of keeping the weight in down. Your minutiae. Your minutiae here. Let the head improve. Thank you. and similar, the same movement, coming cut down, and then from here, release the hand and put through this way. So we allow that hand to change itself. The same body work, release through the hip and slide in the body through. Cut and dominate, release wall. Play with blending these together, so a little bit more than a Gary. You can continue with the basic, resting through this way, or change into a variation in the this way. Just kind of blend it together. And you can try and absorb the impact of the cut to the ground and then pull it out to it. All the time, then re-fold to the ground.
Michael, do you aim for the throat?
Yeah, this one for the throat. Yeah, for this one. Yeah, it's a little bit higher. It's coming for the... Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. Thank you. Aim for the throat.
Yes, I will.
Okay, good. Nice and big. So we link all these super moves together. So start with number one. You come to the back, cutting down. Now come into the left side, Yokomen. Here, right side, Yokomen forward, thrusting through on the left side, then rotate to the back. You've got a Shomen, and then finishing with the Tsuki. Just link to the all, link them all together. Start with number one. Here, Shomen, Yokomen on the left side, Yokomen on the right, number seven. Roll to the back, Shomenichi, right here. In the last minute, so just play freely, just any kind of strikes of Shomen, Yokomen, kind of variation, slicing. Just play with it. So. You guys will see. Another move. Just start to blend the movements together now. Great. Good. Ooh, let's stop that. Good. Let's. Oh, arigato.
Domo arigato.
Domo arigato. Gozaimashita.